An elderly River Hills couple chooses to die together. Tonight, the suicide pact they planned for years and what they wanted it to accomplish after they were gone. The couple told family they hoped their deaths would say something about the way we live. Good evening, I'm Kathy Michaelby.
And I'm Terry Sater. Dr. Daniel and Catherine Gooch committed suicide on Sunday. New at 6, 12 News' Colleen Henry is here. Colleen, the couple's deaths may have stunned the community, but not the family.
Terry, their doctor says he's been talking to the couple about end-of-life planning for more than a decade, and that in their deaths, the couple hoped to spark conversation.
This is not a surprise to me. I just didn't know when.
Sunday night, Dr. Bruce Wilson got the call he'd waited for years. Dan and Kitty Goot were gone.
Dr. Goot was a retired urologist and a sailor, and Mrs. Goot was an avid tennis player for many years and a championship golfer.
Wilson is an old family friend and was the couple's heart doctor. Dan Goot was retired, relatively healthy, and about to turn 80, but his wife Kitty was recently diagnosed with Alzheimer's.
And then you've got a relatively healthy husband left behind who was very much in love with his wife and did not want to live the rest of his life without her.
According to the medical examiner's report, one of their daughters found the couple dead in their car in the garage of their River Hills home. They were surrounded by helium tanks, tubes, and plastic garbage bags. Wilson says the family was not surprised.
He discussed this at great length with all three of his daughters and their families and his grandchildren over a period of years.
But many of the Goots' friends were unaware.
It's not something they were very open about because of their concern that it might be too disturbing for people. Because our culture, it seems, has not been ready for this.
Their obituary lists their accomplishments. Goot was a prominent urologist and once Saukville's town president. Kitty was an environmentalist. They lived life fully and, according to their obituary, chose to leave this world with dignity.
We need to attend to that and not fight death to the last with all of our technology and rob people of the opportunity to have a meaningful thing happen in the last chapter.
The Goots left behind notes for family and police documenting their plan and books and videos about end-of-life issues, so there would be no question that this was a suicide. A memorial service for the Goots is planned in August, Terry.